I just started unrolling that piece of bale that I was telling you about. Look at there. Just what we're looking for.
Check out that 574, y'all. Still making the bait. Hey, everybody. Welcome back. Laying a little more hay down. This is actually second cut. Those of y'all that's been around, it would actually be our third cutting. Y'all know that when we bush hogged it earlier in the year. It's Friday afternoon right now. We started cutting Thursday afternoon. Cut pretty much all night, going straight on into Friday here. Got a good stretch of weather, got like four or five days, I believe. Supposedly of good weather, so we're going to try to make a run at it. So come along here and check it out with us. I'm going to put you in a different couple of spots in the truck and let's see what we got going on.
camera just stopped at during that time lapse. I'll try to put this right in that spot. I stopped to take a picture so I can share it on Instagram and Facebook to keep up with all this stuff. How about that? I'm a little behind the scenes.
All right, we found it. There goes my son wrecking with the 574. We just started bailing. The dude finally got dried off enough. Help out. He didn't even want the canopy put on that thing. He said he's gonna get him a little sun while he's out here today. Done for us though. At the watch this field, we got a power line right there. And I'll show you in a second, it kind of runs across the field. See it right there? They come out last year and they keep raising it up for us as it gets a little sag to it.
Had a little issue with the fuel pickup on the 574. When that tractor gets down to 5-6 gallons in it, pickup gives you a little issue. So long as you keep it way above that, normally don't have much trouble out of it. Let's get back to bailing. Let's walk here and check this bail out while we stop. Sun's that way. Come this way, y'all should be able to see. Look at that. You tell me a cow ain't gonna enjoy that. Tight enough. About as hard as a woodpecker's beak.
Talking about having fuel issues earlier in this video, or the video before, however it works out, y'all saw us cutting hay. Right after I quit recording, we ran this thing out of fuel. Figured I would tell you, to be honest with you. A lot of you just stopped laughing at me for running the truck out of fuel whenever we run out of fuel going to get going the skid loader. Skid steer. Yeah, man, this thing probably took me an hour to get it bled out. Get the air out of it so we could get back to cutting and finish up the other night. Get along with some bailing here and see if we can get some bales knocked out today. Sure is nice having my son on the farm helping us rake today. There he goes, right over there raking. Man, that makes it nice having an extra hands to help to drive a tractor and rake with. Just a minute ago, we was working on that fuel issue. Did he want to put the canopy on? He told me no. So then we can get him a little something. Y'all see the difference on the tin of the windows? See, there's tin and that's not tin. There you go, you can see that. See that combine under the shed? There's no tin. Bad.
make a note?
There's a small roll. I'll explain that roll in just a second. Let's get that rolling right here. All right, we're about finished this field here. As you can see, maybe you can see, we broke a belt. I'm pretty certain that it's in that piece of rock that I just showed you at the end of the field. The next field we go into was not quite dry enough yet. My son just got through tending it out, flooding and tending it, whatever you want to call it. Pretty sure it's in that bale or one of these bales right up here. There's a green rag tied on it. That was the one I tied right before I started that one. So now we're going to see we was going to finish baling today with just missing it. But now that we might get this road here finished, we're done for today. We're going to try to find that bale and splice it back on here. If we can't find it, we'll order some new ones and
I just started unrolling that piece of bale that I was telling you about. And looky.
There.
Just what we're looking for. If it ain't tore up too bad, that is. Now what I'll do is I'll just run right back over this with the baler. Bail it right back up. And we'll go try to splice this bale back in. See what we can get it back together.
Now we're trying to run over where we rolled that bale out at. Like our belt's still fine. The rivet, the splice has come apart, pulled out. That might be the same one that me and Gordon Wright fixed last year. This same field, actually. If it is, I want to say Gordon did do a good job on that splice. Just picking guys and gals. Picking and having fun is what makes the day go by.
A little bit of cow chow out there. All right, the belt length should be right and close enough. We cut it square, took the grinder, grind the cleats out the way, put this little jig in your vise, tight as you can tighten it to your vise, just about bust. There's our 1 foot cheater pipe we tighten it with. What we're thinking about doing is welding us like an 1¼-inch nut right on the end right there, so we can use our 1-inch ratchet instead of having to use a cheater pipe.